I'm Terrell Brown.
And I'm Tanya Babich in for Judy Sue. So it is the last weekend, or we're coming up on the last weekend of winter. And of course, it's going to get a little bit chillier. Just to remind us that we're not quite out of the woods yet. Good morning, Tracy.
Oh, correct. We've seen snow in April and even off to the north. Yes, there is bona fide snow, as you can see, up around Watertown, Maquonago, and then over toward Milwaukee. It's a little bit of a mix. I don't expect any of that to really get in here anytime shortly, but it's 36 degrees out at O'Hare, 38 degrees at Midway, 39 degrees right now in Gary, and we should have a sunny start to our day today, but a chilly one ahead. More on your forecast coming up, but Roz, my top of the show that has traffic being deep. Tanya and Terrell.
Oh, Roz, we're going to have more on that traffic situation now on I-57.
For evidence. Now, right now, there is no description of the shooter, and police say they are still sorting through all of the details. Reporting live on the South Side, Jessica D'Onofrio, ABC 7, Eyewitness News.
Jessica, thank you. Is still under investigation.
A University of Illinois men's basketball player is due in court today on suspicion of domestic.
Ruled a suicide.
Freedom comes today for a former Illinois state representative.
Will leave 450 jobs vacant.
Extreme weather is happening across a good portion of the country this morning with tens of millions of Americans who are impacted. ABC's Lauren Lister has the latest.
Sevens, thankfully, not a whole lot of that around here. But it is getting a little bit chilly, and I know, Roz, you're crazy busy this morning.
Lots going on. Usually Fridays are calm, but not today.
Got it. All right, we'll get to that in just a sec. First, though.
Yeah, weather-wise, it's calm. Yeah, it's just kind of cold. Right. I know, right. Yeah. This morning, we will have sunshine that will be visible. We'll be off to a dry for the afternoon. Clouds will be on the increase later on today. Here's a look at the radar, and nothing showing up in Chicago. You have to get up toward Milwaukee, Racine right now to bump into any wet weather or even any frozen forms of precipitation. And even this afternoon, as we see the clouds increase, our high resolution forecast model is producing some light rain showers around the area. So we'll allow for maybe just a few little spits of some drizzle here this afternoon. Our average high today is 47. Average low is 30 degrees. Yesterday, St. Patrick's Day, 36 degrees right now, though, at O'Hare. And our AccuWeather real feel is 28 degrees. 31 right now in McHenry. It's 31 degrees in Cary. So these temperatures are cold, certainly. 34 in Palatine now. It is 35 degrees in New Lenox, 33 Manteno, and 38 degrees in La Porte and Valparaiso at 36. So our skies are mainly clear. More cloud cover across southern Wisconsin, as well as some of those light snow showers up around Milwaukee right now. Out in the northern plains, they're seeing some snow. What's in store for us over the weekend? Well, here's our Saturday afternoon time period, and it does bring in some light rain showers. I still think it could be cold enough where we could see a few flurries around as we take a look even at our snowcast for tomorrow afternoon and evening. It's suggesting we could get maybe just a little wee dusting around the area. So clouds are going to thicken up once again here this afternoon, and most likely there will be a few showers around. Spring officially arriving here tomorrow night, 11:30 to be exact. And as we look at the weekend, yeah, temperatures are going to be coming in at least 10 degrees below average over the weekend. And looks like some light rain and flurries likely, at least here on Saturday, as winter starts to try to say.
Right around that Oak Street curve, that's because.
You're watching Judy Sue, Terrell Brown, weather with meteorologist Tracy Butler. And Rob.
Accident in Alaska. Sarah Palin says her husband had a long surgery to repair his upper body. In her words, oh, drunken stupors. Federal investigators are looking into a possible cyber attack on GOP frontrunner Donald Trump.
ABC's Kenneth Moten is following this new development in the 2016.
Moten, ABC News, Washington.
New worries this morning about Ebola. The West
going to be below average here over the weekend. Right now, skies are clear in Chicago, but not too far away. Yeah, we're seeing a little snow across Wisconsin. 35 degrees Villa Park. It is 35 degrees right now in Gary. 36 degrees currently in Crown Point. It is 32 out in Sycamore. Bit of a breeze is making it feel like it's in the 20s in numerous spots this morning. Now we will start our day off with some sunshine, but the clouds will be on the increase this afternoon. We might get a couple of showers out of some of those clouds, and our high temperatures today are only going to be heading up into the low 40s. I think over the weekend, especially tomorrow, we're going to have a fair amount of cloud cover in the area.
police. Emergency crews have shut down all lanes between Chicago Avenue and the Oak Street curve. We do have a snapshot. Our crew just arrived on the scene. And
since arriving at the shed.
Oh, cutie. Can't wait to find out the name. Mm-hmm. Time now, 4:49. Coming up, Chicago City Hall on the move. Well, kind of. Details on what may be coming to your neighborhood.
Plus, to keep Blackhawks player injured, we'll chat morning sports next.
With you?
What really happened between her, El Chapo, and Sean Penn? The Diane Sawyer exclusive tonight on E!
Mayor Emanuel is taking City Hall to your neighborhood by holding service fairs. It's so people who live in Chicago can learn more about services and resources available to them. The first service fair is tomorrow at the South Shore Cultural Center. Four other fairs will be held in other neighborhoods in the coming week. Time now, 4:54, ahead in our 5 o'clock hour, more breaking news coverage.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Terrell Brown.
And I'm Tanya Babich, and for Judy Sue, we're going to get things started with a check of the weather.
Yeah, traveling up to Milwaukee, yeah, don't be surprised. You could bump into some light snow up that way. 34 degrees Lincolnshire, it's 37 degrees Burns Harbor and Harvey. Oak Park now at 37 degrees, Bolingbrook at 35. So, temperatures now, low 30s. We have some wind chills this morning in the mid-20s around the area. So it is a brisk start to our day out there. And overall, going to be a brisk day around Chicago with those highs in the 40s.
Situation on I-57 northbound. Crews have just reopened all lanes at 111th after an earlier shooting and police investigation. But traffic is still very heavy from before 119th to 111th. The other serious crash, northbound on Lakeshore Drive, between Chicago and Oak Street, it was a rollover crash with entrapment. Police have now opened up a couple of lanes, so traffic is starting to filter through there. Public, Metra, or Pace. Tanya and Terrell.
Oh, Roz, thank you. So I-57 has reopened. It's not going to slow you down this morning after that shooting, but we are still following that breaking news.
Right. Jessica D'Onofrio live at 111th Street. Jessica.
Tanya and Terrell, police say they are still sorting through all of the details. So far, there's no description of the shooter in this case, but investigators are looking for as much evidence as they can.
Around, I think we start in.